In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a clear and polished organizational chart in Microsoft Word. We'll be walking through the entire process step by step, so by the time you finish watching, you'll know exactly how to build a hierarchy, add people at different levels, and customize the look to fit your needs. Imagine you need to map out your company's chain of command or show the reporting structure in a department. This tutorial will help you create a professional chart that you can easily adjust as your organization grows or changes. Let's jump right in. The first thing you want to do is open a new Word document or any existing document where you want the organizational chart to appear. Once you have Word open, look at the top ribbon and find the Insert tab. Go ahead and click Insert. From there, you'll see different sections for things like pages, tables, pictures, and so on. But the key item to look for here is SmartArt. SmartArt is a feature that lets you insert different types of diagrams, flowcharts, and hierarchy charts with just a couple of clicks. Click on the SmartArt button, and Word will pop up a dialog box with various categories: list, process, cycle, hierarchy, relationship, and a few others. Since we're specifically making an organizational chart, you'll want to select the hierarchy category. Under hierarchy, you'll notice several icons and layouts. You can pick whichever layout you like, but there is a specific layout that tends to work well for most users. And that's typically one with the main box at the top and a straightforward branching layout underneath. If you see an option that shows a simple top box with lines down to secondary boxes and then multiple sub-branches, that's a good starting point. Once you choose the basic hierarchy style, Word will place a starter chart into your document. Next, you might notice that the chart is a bit small, or that you want more space to build out a complex structure. If you want to change how your page is set up so the chart has more room horizontally, you can switch your document to landscape orientation. To do that, look toward the top of Word for the Layout tab. Click on Layout, then find Orientation and switch it from Portrait to Landscape. This will give you a wider page, making it easier to view and manage your chart. You can also resize the chart itself by clicking on any corner of the chart and dragging outward to expand it or inward to make it smaller, depending on how much room you need. Now it's time to start filling out the chart. Usually at the very top of an organizational chart, you'll have the highest level position. For example, if you're mapping out a company, you might type in CEO. To do this, click on the top box in the chart and just start typing. If you already see placeholder text there, just select it and replace it with the person's title or name. Once you type in CEO, you'll probably have some secondary boxes below. These might be positions like CFO, Chief Financial Officer, COO, Chief Operating Officer, or any key direct reports to the person at the top. One handy feature is the text pane, which often appears on the left side after you insert a SmartArt graphic. If it's not visible, look along the top area and find a button that says Text Pane or something similar in the SmartArt tools. When you click on that, a separate panel appears on the side, showing each box in your chart as a line in the panel. This text pane lets you type titles or names in a list format, and Word automatically arranges them in the chart. If you like to work line by line, this is a fast way to reorganize or rename positions without having to click each box in the visual chart. Let's say under the CEO, you have a CFO on one side and a COO on the other side, but you also need to add someone else, like a general counsel, in the same tier. You can select the CEO's box first because that's the person to whom the new position will report, and then find the option labeled Add Shape. Sometimes you'll see it near the top in the SmartArt Tools Design tab. When you click the drop-down next to Add Shape, you'll see several choices: Add Shape After, Add Shape Before, Add Shape Above, Add Shape Below, and Add Assistant in some chart types. If you want a position that reports directly to the CEO, choose Add Shape Below. That will insert a new box right underneath the CEO. Then you can type in the new position, say General Counsel. Another way to add shapes is by right-clicking on any existing box in the chart. A small menu appears, and you might see an Add Shape option there too. This can be helpful if you don't want to keep moving back and forth to the top toolbar. Similarly, if you've added a position box but decide you don't actually need it, you can click on that box and press the backspace or delete key on your keyboard and it disappears. And this comes in handy when you're trying to fine-tune the number of direct reports or if someone leaves the organization and you want to remove their role from the chart. Suppose you have a CFO box. and by default, it might show two or three boxes beneath it that you don't need. If you want to remove those extra boxes, just select each one and press backspace. If instead you need additional subordinates, you can right-click on the CFO box and select Add Shape below to keep building out the structure. Let's say you name these roles Deputy Chief Financial Officer or Finance Manager, and so on, depending on how you want your organization depicted. Another scenario is if the COO has various direct reports. Maybe you have multiple departments such as marketing, IT, and operations. You can select the COO box, then use the Add Shape Below command for each department head you need. If you want to place them side by side, you can also choose Add Shape After while selecting any sibling shape in the same row. That might sound complicated, but it's just Word's way of saying insert another position on the same level, horizontally. Once those boxes appear, you can label them, for example, Head of Marketing, Head of IT, or Head of Operations. If you need to go a step further and add sub-departments or team leaders under each department head, do the same procedure. Right-click the department head box, choose Add Shape below, and type in that person's title. If you want to adjust the hierarchy manually, maybe you realize a position should actually be above or below another box, you can use the Promote and Demote buttons. You'll find these in the SmartArt Tools area up top or by right-clicking on the position. Promoting a shape generally moves it one level up in the hierarchy, while demoting moves it one level down. You can also use a left-to-right flip option if you need to rearrange which box is on the left or which is on the right. This is handy if you'd like marketing to appear before IT or vice versa, just to keep the chart in an order that feels logical to you. Another neat trick is using the Tab key and Shift plus Tab key when you're working in the text pane. Let's say you have the text pane open on the side. If you type in a position under the CFO but want to make it a subordinate, you can press the Tab key at the beginning of that line, and the new position is indented under the CFO in the chart. If you press Shift plus Tab, it moves the box one level up. This is a quick keyboard shortcut method, especially helpful if you're creating a large chart and don't want to keep switching your mouse back and forth. Once you've fleshed out your main positions, subpositions, and the entire structure looks the way you want, you might want to change the overall style. When you have the chart selected, look at the top for the SmartArt tools. You should see options for layout and styles. By exploring these, you can pick a design that suits your needs. Maybe a colored layout that highlights each box with a different color, or a more subtle, professional scheme. You can also try different layouts within the hierarchy category. Just remember, some layouts are geared toward images if you want to insert photos, but you can definitely stick to a simple text-based layout if all you need are titles and names. If you do pick a style with an image placeholder, you can click inside that placeholder to insert a photo from your computer. This can be useful if you're distributing an organizational chart to a team and you want everyone to recognize faces as well as names. But if that's not necessary for your document, you can ignore the photo placeholders and just use the simpler style that displays each person's name and title. And that's it. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe for more tutorials and tips that will help you get the most out of your documents. And now, YouTube thinks this next video will turn you into a Microsoft Office pro. Watch it or spend the rest of your life manually adjusting line spacing. No pressure. See you there.